What's going on, gamers? Today, we are going to go over how to install and use the Minecraft mod Neat. Before we get started, don't forget to like, subscribe, and click that notification bell to stay up to date on all future videos. One of my biggest pet peeves in games is not knowing when a mob or a challenger is going to die. You can hit a mob over and over again and never know just how close they are to their demise. This can easily be fixed using a couple of different mods, but today we're going over Neat. This will let you view any entity's health bar, including other players. And whether you're playing on a server or a single player world, using this mod is straightforward and easy, even down to the configuration, so let's get started. Head towards Neat for Forge or Fabric on CurseForge and then press the Files option. From here, click View All near the right-hand side of the page, and then you can select your desired game version from the drop-down menu near the top right. Find the mod version you want and then press the Download button to the right-hand side, and save this file somewhere easily accessible to use in just a minute. This modification is completely client-side, meaning you won't need to install it on your server for it to work. That being said, you are going to want to make sure you have either Forge or Fabric installed on your launcher, which of course we have guides to that I will link down below. Open your Minecraft launcher and then head to the Installations area in the top, and then find your installed Forge or Fabric instance and click on the folder icon to the right. Find and open the mods directory and then drag and drop the mod file inside. If you don't have a mods file in this area, then you can easily just make one yourself by creating a new folder and naming it mods. After you've done that, you can head back to the launcher and press play to load the mod. After the installation, you're going to notice health bars on every passive and hostile entity in-game, also applying to players and bosses. This is pretty much the extent of the mod, but there are some configurable options that you can change when it comes to the health bar, so let's go over them. Like I said, you can make changes like making the health bar size smaller or switching its render distance in-game. Regardless of the changes you decide to make, you are going to need to download Notepad or another editing program to start the process. This is going to be required to open and use the configuration file. Once you do that, you can shut down Minecraft and open up the launcher again, and then head back into installations, find your modded profile, and click the folder icon to the right. Find and enter the config directory, and then search for the Neat client file. Open this file with your external program, and then make any necessary changes, and then after editing the settings, you can save and close the file to try it out in-game. As for the types of changes you can make to the files, here are a few examples that might help you get started. As you play with the mod, it might become frustrating to have large health bars. For instance, surviving a swarm of zombies can become overwhelming due to all of the different HP counters in your face. Here is the configuration that we use that might be good for you too, but if you need to change any of the values to work better, feel free to adjust them. Instead of having every health bar displayed automatically, it might even be better to make it appear only when you look at a mob. This is also great for only showing mobs with damaged health, making it so you can only see it when you initiate combat. If after installing the mod, nothing works, make sure you've done it for the correct launcher profile. So if you installed a Forge mod, then make sure you're using a Forge version. You'll also want to make sure the game version is the same as well, so if you choose to download a 1.19.2 version of Neat, then you're going to need that same version of Forge. In cases where your settings aren't saving, make sure to close your game out before making any changes to the files. That being said, it could also be due to an incorrect format or a setting. For example, make sure to either use true or false with no capitalization or typos for it to work. Save any changes and then restart the game again. Seeing the health of an entity I'm fighting in-game is a huge plus for me, since I know exactly how far away I am from their defeat. And with Neat, now that is easy to do. That's all for this one, gamers. As always, I hope you have lots of fun.
Thanks for watching. If you want to see more great content like this, then subscribe or click these videos. Until next time, gamers.